We're on picture number 8 now. Some of the students were so excited about doing a good show for graduation, they became careless. Someone accidentally knocked over a lantern in the costume room, and a small fire started. Well, do you know what can happen if a small fire is not put out right away? That's right. It turns into a big fire.
Hey, do you smell smoke?
Yeah, and I see smoke too.
So do I.
Fire!
Fortunately, the elves and wood sprites had practiced fire drills once a month. They all knew the proper exit doors and how to act in an emergency. Almost everyone got out right away, but a few students were still trapped inside on the top floor of the theater. And one of them was Wooly. See Wooly and Leota in the theater?
Don't worry, I'll think of something.
Now Wooly was sorry he'd changed the way he was. He knew the fire would have been out by now if he were his normal, huge self.
I'm scared, Wooly.
Me too.
Gosh, I hope all the other kids got out okay. My fault. If I were still big, I know I could put the fire out all by myself.
A group of wood sprites flew through the flames and up to the window where Wooly and the others were trapped. With Wooly's help, they managed to carry the trapped students to safety. But even the shrunken Wooly was too heavy for them to lift.
Oh, that's okay. You guys saved yourselves.
The wood sprites were determined to save Wooly. Four of them teamed up and lifted Wooly in the air. Meanwhile, Gimmick had just finished making a new Gramble Stoppet for the portable reducing machine, and it was working perfectly. But we quickly forgot about that when one of the wood sprites flew in through the window. She had come to tell us about the fire and to ask for our help. A fire? At the school tree? In the theater? Gimmick, let's get the airship! We packed up the portable reducing machine and headed for the Elf Village. The flames from the fire were still shooting into the sky as we circled the school tree and landed. Quick, everyone! Grab these buckets! Since we were bigger than the elves and wood sprites, we were able to pour lots of water on the fire. A bucket brigade of bugs flew in from the forest to help out too, but the fire was still burning. Gimmick, why don't we use the reducing machine to make Wooly big again? Then he could carry the big water barrel down the hill. We could put out the fire much faster if that water were close by.
Good idea, Teddy.
Gimmick aimed the machine at Wooly. And in a second, he was back to his normal size. There's Wooly in picture number 11. Wooly charged up the hill and lifted the big barrel over his head. But instead of bringing the water over to us, Wooly charged toward the burning building and poured the whole barrel of water onto the fire.
That oughta do it!
Hooray!
Yay!
Hooray
for Wooly! The fire was finally out. Fortunately, no one was hurt, but the fire had done a lot of damage.
What a mess! Our show is ruined!
Come on, don't be like that! We got a whole day to fix everything, and now that I'm big again, we can do it lots faster.
Everyone worked together to rebuild the theater. Some of it would take months to fix, but with a lot of work, we thought we could fix it well enough for the show the next night. And sure enough, just before showtime...
Hey, we did it, everybody!
I can't believe that everything's ready. It seems scientifically impossible, doesn't it, Gimmick? The show was about to start. Wooly helped get all the sets into place.
Hurry, Wooly. It's time for the air ballet.
Okie dokie.
The Wood Sprites air ballet was beautiful. In fact, the whole show went really well. Then it was time for all the students to sing the special graduation song.
This year at the school tree has been
passed out the graduation diplomas. The first one went to someone who had overcome many difficulties during the school year. Someone who showed everyone at the school that whether he's large or small, his heart is very, very big. My friend, the Woolly What's-It. See? The last picture shows Leota giving Woolly his diploma.
Oh, gee! Thanks, everybody!
We were all very proud of Woolly for learning to just be himself. Well, I hope you enjoyed hearing about Big Little Woolly. Please join me for another picture show. Bye-bye! Why don't you come on the plane to my picture show? Come along, come along, come along, let's go. Oh, I really want to go to the picture show. Come along with me.